Hello ladies and gentlemen, this is Bastion Slot with some exclusive gameplay for Planet Zoo. I say exclusive, everyone else is going to be showing you fairly similar gameplay. When I was over at Gamescom in Germany with Planet Zoo over the last couple of weeks, we were able to do a behind closed door recording session of the game, playing on a different level. We were playing with a developer with us, they're actually a member of the QA team, a really, really nice woman who helped me out and kind of guided me through this, and it was behind closed doors. We weren't allowed to tell anyone about it because we're going to reveal a few brand new animals in this video. Now, I haven't got the original audio that wasn't provided to me, but I do have my file, this file here, the video recording. It is 56 minutes long, so my plan is to basically sit here and commentate for the entire thing, tell you what's going on, tell you what I'm seeing, talk to you about the experience, talk to you a bit about Gamescom. We'll just end up making stuff up by the end, I'm sure, but hopefully I'll be able to show you off 1, 2, 3, 4, I believe, new animals, if not 5, I don't know for sure, but something like that. Anyways, first things first, this was a closed little slice of the game that we got to play. This incredible looking zoo, this is all built, I'm going to say the words, piece by piece, all built piece by piece. This entire thing, this Indian themed looking area, and it really does look incredible. It's a little bit weird, perhaps. It doesn't quite look like a normal zoo, you'd say, but it definitely looks really, really cool. I just want a quick little shout out and thanks to Frontier for letting me do this behind closed door stuff. This is, of course, alpha gameplay. There's a couple of iffy things that go on here. And I will say this is the very first time I ever played... Oh, there's a rhinos, by the way. I should click on one in a second. But basically, when we spawned in, they were on the run a little bit. I believe it's the Indian rhino, isn't it? Yes, it's the Indian rhinoceros. Of course, that was new at the time, but has since been revealed via the IGN articles. As I'm saying, this was the very first time I ever played Planet Zoo, so the actual gameplay skill level might be a little bit iffy here and there. I actually did this before my first stream. I did this on the Monday. I streamed the next day on the Tuesday. So that's why I was maybe a little bit more capable in the stream and utterly useless in this video. But the first thing we're going to do... Oh, Hippo has escaped. We're going to rebuild the barrier. I'm going to screw that up instantly, as you can see. We're going to rebuild the barrier and move our rhinos, I should say, not hippos, back to their exhibit. There's a few things working in this that weren't also working in the demo as well, which I'll try to point out as we go. But we get to see the animal collection kind of bit. And you can see Indian elephant there as well. A little glimpse of the Indian elephant. So what we're going to do is put down a zookeeper. Is it a vet? I think it might be a vet, actually. You know what? I don't know who that is. I think it looks like a vet to me. They've got a tranquilizer gun. They're ready to go. They're shooting. I suspect that might ragdoll a little bit more. Of course, we've all seen this. The animals disappear in these teeny tiny boxes. And because the rhinos escaped from this exhibit down here, the vets, or the zookeepers, whoever it is in the situation, knows to take the rhinos right back to their original exhibit. You don't need to direct them. I actually didn't do anything to these guys. They just kind of did it themselves. They're going to run back over. They're going to drop the rhinos off. And there you go. Beautiful. And the animals will, generally speaking, avoid being inside each other. That's just because we kind of spawn them. But that's Pichu and Pihu, I should say. Pihu. There he is. Beautiful. Nice little look at the rhino for you folks there. I did try to get good looks at all of the new animals. I'm not going to spoil anything, although it's already in the title, I'm sure. If you do want to see just the new animals, I will try to provide timestamps in the description down below. No guarantee, I am recording this at about 7 in the morning. I kind of didn't realize my audio hadn't recorded till about half an hour ago. And had a few drinks with some people and decided to get my work done before sleeping, which may have been a bad idea. We shall see. So there's going to be a lot of getting used to the controls a little bit, messing around the different cameras, seeing our rhinos play around with the different enrichment items. The flooring is generally still this kind of savanna kind of feeling that we saw in a lot of the other zoos along the way, but I don't know, the rhinos look great to me. I love rhinos. Rhinos are like one of my favourite animals in the world, but the kind of the way the plating, the skin plating kind of shifts with the body looks beautiful. And you may have just spotted something there. We'll come back to it later, I promise. We're going to see all of the animals, I swear. Here we're going to get a little look at some of our... Look how cute he is! This is our pronghorn antelope. Actually, one of the new animals. Sort of confirmed. Look, some defecating there. Sort of confirmed. But here is your official proper confirmation as well. Very exciting. They are utterly adorable. I think we have enough antelope now that all look vaguely similar. We've got like three that all look kind of the same. Hopefully there's not more than that, but they are super cute, as you can see. I really, this is very quality, high quality footage. I'm kind of impressed with Frontier right now. I had a really good time recording this. This was the first time I ever got my hands on Planet Zoo. The QA developer I was with was a lovely, lovely person who guided me through and put up with me being obnoxious at several points as I tried to show off different things, you know, for the sake of you guys at home, basically. I'm not sure we should be able to point that out along the way, but I really do try to focus on the animals as much as possible, as you can see by the long time spent looking at the pronghorns. And basically the idea is we're going through this, I don't want to call it a tutorial, but every exhibit has a couple of problems. So what we're going to do is go through and just fix them up, stuff like that. Kind of like what you saw with the British Zoo in the streaming, but a little less intense. You know, things aren't going utterly bloody mental. We're just kind of working our way along. But there's Emelina, our pronghorn antelope. You see her habitat is maybe, oh, she's just, yeah. There's this thing wherein every animal I clicked on decided to defecate pretty much instantly. It was kind of a continued theme in my gameplay, so you may notice that for the next 50 minutes or so. Fun for the whole family. I love that. Look at him carrying the little, I mean, it kind of looks like a weight, you know, those weights that you get, the one hand weights, but it's adorable. And he just drops it, wanders along, does their thing. And this is, she was explaining to me how we do the terrain tools for the very first time. So we're gonna, you're seeing this already in the stream. Of course, the goal is to bring up the white bars and bring down the white bars to make, well, I say the white lines to make it fit within the bars, basically. And it's a pretty cool system. I do have one problem with the system in that you'll have exhibits where you've got like, I don't know, it's all perfect except you have 1% too much long grass or something like that, and it's in the red, right? You want to get into green. Look at that, beautiful. I'm an expert after 7 minutes. But you'll have like 1% too much long grass and you want to get it down into the green, and to find that 1% proves to be really annoying. It'd be really nice if there's a way to it'd be really nice. I did this myself. Look how cute that is. Seriously, look at that, beautiful, absolutely beautiful. It'd be really nice if there's a way to sort of more visibly see the different terrain tools, just in like a little edit mode, so you can pinpoint them and knock them out. But, you know, it's not the end of the world. It's like one of my minor annoyances, to say the least. I mean, look at the zoo. How cool does that zoo look? The answer? Very cool. Well done. Correct answer. I did consider cutting this down, but, yeah, there we go. Ladies and gentlemen, Baird's tapir. And a pooper scoop. Again, trying to get you a really nice view of the animals. We're gonna see later on into the video the baby tapir, and it is, I mean, look at that guy. The baby tapir is absolutely adorable. It looks exactly what you'd expect, you know, the little stripy thing. The way this one lies down is a little bit weird. The back legs, I think, maybe need moving or editing a little bit. It looks a little awkward to me, but beyond that, it's just, it's perfect. It's fluffy, but not too fluffy. The animations are great. The ear flicks, of course. I'm hoping we also get a Malaysian tapir as well, but we'll see. But anyways, we looked at terrain for the first one. Now we're going to look at the enrichment. You can see our tapir doesn't have food enrichment or just general entertainment enrichment, which are the two main types you're going to experience in the game. So we got to go into the enrichment items and pick some relevant ones for the tapir. And I believe she explains here how to use the filter menu, which I will click the right button. There we go. Well done, past best in slot. You can see a couple of animals there, but nothing we've not seen before. Oh, no, there you can see a couple there. Yep, I'm not going to talk about them. They're going to be later on in the video, okay? There's two there that are brand new as well. One of which was a little bit disappointing. One of them is just awesome. Oh, no, there, I'm just going to show you all of them. I remember actually saying the words, I'm going to have to do this. I have to do this for YouTube. Yeah, so Mandrill, Himalayan brown bear, Gharial. Those are the big three for later in the video, along with the tapir. The Gharial is awesome. It really is. I know we knew it was coming. I know we saw the skin and we thought it was the Gharial, but you know, we all thought it was a bloody reticulated python or whatever it was. I can't actually remember what we had decided it was, but the point is we got the snake wrong, so the chance of the Gharial, it seemed sure, but it wasn't definite, and it looks really cool. The brown bear, the Himalayan brown bear, is okay. It just looks a little bit too much like the grizzly to be that interesting, but the tapir looks great. I'm sure there's other stuff. I can't remember what the... Oh, the mandrel. The mandrel looks awesome as well. Again, we'll see all of these further into the video. So this is the heat map kind of thing. And this is very useful for, well, heat, basically. Especially in an environment like this. You can have your colder preferring animals living in the hotter environments, but you're going to need to give them a way to cool down. So we're trying to place like coolers and stuff like that. You know, you can see a little bit of cool things down. That's a sprinkler, actually. That's an enrichment item. That just gives them general enjoyment, but it also cools them down a little bit in these really warm environments. So it's kind of got like a dual use. And you can see there the heat map goes down just a little bit. I will say, I mentioned this a little bit in my first video. Oh, yeah. So I'm going to explain something here. I just kind of decided to stick down every enrichment item because that's the kind of person I am. The woman I was with instantly told me that you can do this in theory, but there is a slight problem with this. Now, if you have an animal with an enrichment item, eventually, and you'll see this is why I'm deleting them, the animal will grow bored of those enrichment items, and they'll provide like less rating. I don't think it'll ever be zero, but it'll definitely not be max. That's the impression I got. So the idea is, you want to, every now and again, and I don't get the feeling it's something you'll have to do often, but every now and again, you're going to want to mix up the enrichment that you provide to your animals. They do it in real zoos. It's like in real life. You go to the gym, right? You have to mix up your weights. You have to mix up your routine every now and again. Otherwise, your body kind of gets used to things. The same idea, really is. So you want to mix up your enrichment items in order to keep your animals truly entertained. We had this lovely glow here. These were all piece by piece little lights stuck onto the wall. I just really love the glow on the tapir. That's a big old feeder enrichment item. Just look at this zoo. How cool is this zoo? Even if it's not my personal aesthetic with the light colours and stuff like that, I think it's awesome. It really is. The creativity in this game is off the freaking chain. I've seen people already build some amazing stuff, you know, over streamers and stuff like that. Maybe beyond me, but we're going to do our best. There he goes, pooper scooping away. I'll speed up time a little bit. Well, tapirs. They're cool, right? I think they're really cool. The baby, man. The baby. We're going to see a little bit later on as well. Don't know how I'm going to talk for another 40 minutes. Half drunk, half asleep. But on we go. Gharial time. Look at him. Now, I don't believe I show him in the daytime, and I'm very sorry about that. But even at nighttime, I mean, that is awesome, isn't it? I actually think this is my favourite animal in the entire game at this point in time. I don't know if it's even close. Look at him, he's awesome. What else do I say other than that? He is absolutely awesome. The snout, the mouth, that whole area just looks really, really cool. He looks unique, he stands out. Oh, he looks so happy. He's a unit, he's massive. Easily my favourite animal in the game. I don't think it's even close. Which does, albeit confirm, there are enough sloths at this point in time. I didn't ask, I'll admit. I didn't really ask much. I should have gone in with more questions, maybe get some hints. I did get one cheeky hint for the future. I promise I'll bring that up later on in the video when it's relevant. But there's Rishi, our gharial. You can see Rishi has a couple of problems. I just wanted to have a look at Rishi swimming around for a little bit, first of all. Look at that. You could build like a little horror film and everything. Da-da-da-da. Yeah, it's Jaws, but... Ooh, crocodiles have jaws. So, I apologise. The water is filthy. You can see that when you drop the camera under, the water is noticeably dirty. It's not that clear. You can't really see in that well. The solution to that is to build a water filter, and that is what we're going to do next. Look at that. We're just standing at the edge looking over. Rishi walks over. A little bit damper as well. All the tourists having a good time. She clearly doesn't care that much about the privacy of the whole situation, considering she's not very private at all. But what we need is a water treatment plant. Now, I don't believe this was in the stream. This is actually new to the Behind Closed Doors demo, which I got the feeling was a little bit further on. And the idea is this has like a little bit of a radius around it. You can see there, the blue radius, and it cleans the water within that radius. And this is like other things in the game, other staff buildings. You're going to want to keep these out of the way of your guests and stuff like that. We aren't going to do that. My plan was to have it so it hit the exhibit here and the exhibit on the... There's another exhibit somewhere that it hits, I believe. I'm going crazy. Either way, for the purposes of the Behind Closed Doors demo, I just kind of stuck it on the side. Eventually, I stick it on the side. Eventually, I stick it... Best in slot. Come on. Come on. You're going to put it there. I know you are. Go on. There we go. So eventually, like I said, you're going to want to hide that away somewhere, just like your staff buildings. You're going to want to have a little staff path to your transformers. Honestly, the layout for your zoos is actually really, really important. It's something you're going to want to pay attention to. But you can see that it's got this big grid around. It's also supplied by that local power unit as well, which again has like a circle radius around it. So it's kind of just using the circle radiuses and overlapping things as need be. And that's going to clean everything in the area, which if you have, particularly for your gharials and your other aquatic-esque creatures, clean water, as you can see, beautifully clean and clear water. That is a very important thing. That makes a lot of sense. I love it so much. I don't really know what else to say. I think it's, oh, look at her. Just makes me happy. Him. It's him, isn't it? It's a dude. Look at him. He just makes me happy. Genetic makeup, not the biggest gharial. See, this is a 41%er as well. We believe that, we can't really get a straight answer on this quite yet, but we believe how the system works is your animals only have two life stages, right? They are babies slash children, and then the adults. But we believe that when they're born as adults, they then grow across their lifespan until death, depending on their size statistic. So at 41%, Rishi would never be absolutely massive. So you could have a gharial not twice as big, but I imagine maybe a fifth, quarter, is like quarter bigger, something like that. I don't know, an absolute unit. I think that's it for the gharial anyway. And her lovely, his lovely. Rishi just sounds female to me. We're going to move on to the tiger now. No, we're not. We're going to move on to the mandrills, yes. Now, of course, the most exciting thing about a mandrill is the booty. It is, of course, the males who have the booty. It's, and they're defecating. I told you it's a thing every time. But it is going to take me a little bit of a time to find the appropriate booty. But this is a great looking exhibit, to say the least. So we're going to see a little bit of that with Titalayo or Mandrill. I know people have really, really wanted some monkeys and stuff in the game. So I think people are going to be excited about the mandrills. I actually saw people on the Discord mention specifically wanting mandrills lately. So hopefully people are excited about this. I promise you I will show you a male ass at some point in this video. But doesn't the exhibit look great? It really does. We are going to see some climbing as well, soon-ish. It doesn't look great. It didn't look great in the streaming. It doesn't look great in the behind closed doors demo. I'm going to call it Roger, okay? The demo was called Roger. It didn't look great in Roger. That just sounds weird. But this is alpha. It's not even the beta. This is the alpha version. We're actually about to see the male right here climbing upstairs. And it gets... Oh, it's a bebe. Is that a bebe? Look at that booty. Oof. I think that's a baby over there. Rawr, look at him, doesn't he look great? And he's going to get a little bit funky here, as you'll see. There he goes. He gets much funkier later on, but we'll get there. I have full faith that this is something that's going to be improved over time. I think this is one of the things that just gets tightened up a little bit in those last couple of months. There's no guarantee, and if it doesn't, feel free to complain. But my point is, it is an alpha build at the moment, so we've got to have some faith that things like this will cease to be a problem down the line. Well, that's good though. I did have a slight problem with the cinematic camera. It's always far away. Like, it very rarely gave me a nice close-up shot. The orbit camera just felt more useful. But there we go. There's our Adumbi the mandrill. Beautiful creature. Beautiful. Speaking rather generally, I did kind of do a mini review the other week. But just to say, in my opinion, Planet Zoo really did control great. I did have some lag issues on the stream, but that was after a crash and after I accidentally reset it and stuff like that. In this hour-long gameplay we're doing right here, this behind closed doors demo, in this Roger, I had no lag problems whatsoever. I had no crash problems. My biggest problem was the animations being a little bit weird. That is it. It really wasn't a problem at all. The game is in a good state. It needs a little bit of sprucing up here and there, but generally speaking, I would say the game is looking pretty damn good, actually. And I really enjoyed it. I know I've hyped things up in the past. I am well aware of this. But I honestly think it's a really, really cool game. And especially really creative players are going to get a lot of good out of this game. Even if you're not, though. Myself included, maybe. We'll be able to download stuff online. We'll be able to, hopefully. We haven't had confirmation on that either, but we're hoping we'll be able to download other people's blueprints, kind of like what Planet Coaster was like when Planet Coaster first came out. So if you want to download a big Indian style building like this that someone else has designed, you'll be able to do that. No confirmation on that though, just take that with a hint of salt, but that is definitely the accepted idea. Here you're going to see what I was on about a little bit before, where we're trying to get the grass up a little bit and the soil up a little bit, but without knocking everything else down. To be honest, I probably didn't handle it that well. I was, like I say, very, very new to the game. The system isn't that bad, especially when you're kind of starting a new zoo. I think you'll be absolutely fine. We came into this all the time with like very pre-built exhibits, which probably makes it more difficult. And if I'm honest, I probably didn't handle it that well, as you can see. I think it's probably easier than I'm making it look. I don't know, I was just very happy to be playing the game. What can I say? There we go, we finally got there. Beautiful. I'm sure it gets worse later on. But there is still a problem. So, they've got all the size they need. Loads of it, like way more size than they need. They've got all the terrain they need, but what they also need is some climbing items. So I've set my filter to climbable on that second tab on the left. And then we're going to put in some climbing structures, like the climbable frame, stuff like that. So again, these are kind of blueprints you'd be able to get hold of. But if you wanted to build your own, you could do that as well. That's the good thing about the game. You really do have the control over how you want to do it. There we go. Bam. Now, I'm pretty sure I do at some point trying to make my own, but I'm pretty sure I gave up pretty quickly, unfortunately. It's something I wish I'd spent a lot more time with. One of my larger regrets with my time in the game is I didn't explore this a little bit. But you get all these, you'll see in a second, the tools are quite advanced for how we move things around and rotate them. And if you want stuff to flow, I believe you can do that. There you go, see? Reminded me of playing on 3DS Max back in the day. There we go, you can duck things under the earth if you want, hide them half underground. You really do have control, that's the main thing I really always felt when playing this game. You have the control. I felt great. I've been talking a lot, I don't know how I've been talking 21 minutes. Women, the women folk squaring up to each other a little bit, having a little monkey fight. Oh. Who will emerge as champion of the monkey fight? That is the question, folks. So you'll see here they both decided to actually go inside after the monkey fight because it's raining. And he'll end up doing the same. Is that our male? I think that's our male. They'll go under trees, they'll go under buildings, they'll basically go under anything that has a shelter. And you'll actually see under trees, not get as wet as out of trees and stuff like that, I believe. Basically, everything that gives shelter will literally give shelter, and your animals will want to hide in them. But you see, we have a nice, happy exhibit. Titty Lio is having the time of Titty Lio's life. We're going to turn off the rain here a little bit, mess around the time of day just a little bit. We did actually do this in our stream, so if you do want to check out a little bit of a day-night cycle, you can do that in the stream, but not something I went into too much detail in, I will admit. Now, the goal was to speed up time here, as you can see, to hopefully see one of our lovely mandrills climb up the climbing frame. I really wanted to experience the climbing, because I hadn't seen it. This is, again, before the stream. Decided to have some food first, and I decided to build a terrible, terrible little climbing frame. I mean, technically, I don't know how you know what their minimum gap is, if that makes sense, like how far can they jump. I don't know if there's going to be a system for that in the game to tell you, or is it something you're just going to have to figure out and kind of get used to over time yourself. I believe they could climb up this, maybe. I know it's beautiful, I know you're all blown away by my skills, but there you go. You're about to see some slightly funky climbing, as you can see, unfortunately. I mean, they jumped off fine. It's a really, really cool system that I don't believe I've ever seen. Oh, this is my favourite. Where is it? And that one's okay, actually. It's climbing up the middle. Climbing up the middle. That wasn't so bad. That wasn't so bad. There they go. It's, yeah. It's not great right now. But again, I believe this is a system. I've honestly just never seen a system like this in the game at all. That probably didn't help that I was on double speed as well. And it definitely needs some love before the game comes out, but if it functions correctly and the animations all go together really nicely and stuff like that, and it looks not like this, it's gonna be awesome. There's a lot of climbable animals that climb, I should say, in the game, and between these and the lemurs and your big cats and everything, and seeing them all climbing over your custom built structures, it's going to be very, very cool if they iron out the kinks a little bit. Back to the tapirs, because it's swimming. I thought that was cool. I'm a simple man. Show me a big wet swimming animal and I'm in there. They also need some plant coverage, which I believe is the first time I got to mess around with this. There's so many different things that make up an exhibit. You've got your enrichment, you've got your food and your water, you've got your terrain, you've got the climbable objects, you've got the coverage. And the coverage is tons and tons of different plants, and you can filter them by the correct biome and by the correct continent to give your, in this case, tapirs, what they need. You can't actually sort by species, which is surprising. But I think we went for temperate, they weren't all in the game at this point. Although I believe all the ones we needed were. And then we go for South Central America. Just gonna point out polar there. Polar. I mean, I don't think we see anything. Is a snow leopard polar? I don't think so. I don't think we see any of the polar animals at this point in time. Now, is it just a biome for style, or is it a biome for specific polar animals? Are we going to see penguins? Are we going to see polar bears? Stuff like that. I think yes, but I will say I don't know. I have no confirmation, I have no information about that. But just based on the presence of that polar biome and stuff like that, and the polar plants and stuff like that, I would wager a guess that it may just be the case. There we go. Coverage just got on 17%. The tapir quite likes a lot of coverage. Of course, tapirs do typically live in quite a jungle-esque environment, so they're usually happier with a little bit more coverage, a little bit more plant life and stuff like that. But again, you've got like a little bit of leeway. It's the same with the other animals. We saw in the stream I made an exhibit where my warthog, lemurs and tortoises were all happy, which is pretty cool, right? They weren't all 100% happy, but they were all happy, they all survived. Now what we're going to do is make our own exhibit, kind of. This is a Bengal tiger habitat, but you can see it's not finished quite yet, so this was me messing around with the barrier system for the first time. And I'm going to talk about something I actually mentioned. Yeah, I found the barrier system a little difficult to use. I did a swell when I was streaming, if I'm totally honest, but again, that might just be a me thing more than anything else, but the customization of the barrier system is very, very cool, so I'm just going to drag this along, making a beautiful big ass concrete purple fence. I think you'll all agree it's gorgeous. What you doing? Oh, I'm changing the colour. I actually don't remember. I haven't watched this already. We're going orange. It's a tiger exhibit. I gotta be on point thematically. I like the idea of doing like a black orange, black orange, black orange, and just being super obvious about it, but that'll do for now. Exactly, my friend, exactly. And that'll automatically jump on there. Lovely stuff. So we can put the tiger in there now. Do we do that? Or are we doing the windows? Let's find out. Let's find out together. We're on a journey of discovery together, ladies and gentlemen. There we go. So what we're going to do is mess around with the window system, where you can put a window into basically most of the barriers in the game. And this wasn't working on the stream, but it did work on the behind closed doors demo. You can select multiple pieces of barrier by hitting that button. We select our glass, and we can also select one-way glass, like that. And that means, of course, your guests can see in, or alternatively, if you wanted, you could have an exhibit where your animals can see out, like this one, but your guests can't see in. You can see how it's darker on this side. It's like one-way tinted glass in, you know, Lamborghini for the Mafia. Same idea. I don't know why you'd ever want to do that, but in theory, you could, if you decided to do that. Again, I don't know why you would, but maybe you would. Maybe you're a crazy person. And in that, you can change which direction the glass goes. So we click that right to left instead, and you can see it's now the correct way. So from this side, we can see into the exhibit what will be a Bengal tiger exhibit. But from the other side, come on, Bessonslot, from the other side, maybe. Come on, buddy. Come on. No, I'm talking about something. I'm definitely talking about something. I'm sure it was fascinating and entertaining and important. Yes, quite. Ugh. Come on, show the other side. Don't be stupid. Well, you've already seen what it looks like. The point is, now what that's really good is your guests can see your tiger, but your tiger can't really see out, and that increases their privacy. It's obviously a good thing. You want your animals to be happy and private. Also, tigers are expensive. So we buy a tiger. We're going to see that whole delivery process and stuff like that. And of course, I had a cheeky little scroll down because I had to, really, just because it's the first time playing the game, right? So the gharial, which, oh god, I love the gharial. And then any animal you buy goes to the Animal Trade Center, gets stored. You can store up to 99 animals, as you can see. I believe I don't know what I'm doing, actually, at this point in time.
Yep, we went back. Yeah, there we go. And then Center Zoo and click to what is already called the Bengal Tiger exhibit. But the exhibits, I believe, do get auto-renamed based on what animals you put in them the first time. I don't really know how that works. I didn't really get to play around with that, but... Oh, I'm tired. Sorry. Oh, it is like... Actually, what time is it? This is a very professional video. I really liked this. Look, the rhinos and the tigers had this little crossover barrier kind of thing. I was fascinated by that. It's awesome. I was fascinated by that. I don't know why that made me really happy, but it's just like this little detail, this little impenetrable barrier, but the rhinos and tigers could, in theory, look across at each other every now and again. Maybe fall in love, get like a Romeo and Juliet situation going on, you know? Anyways, what are we doing next? Let's find out. Ah, this was a believed, yes, the donation box. So if you've got a nice exhibit, one of the best ways you're going to make money in your zoo is by having donation boxes. You know, you want it right by the windows so your guests can see in and decide, you know, they want to support that animal in particular. They love the tiger because the tiger's awesome. They're going to give some money to your zoo, and that's going to be like a really important, and I was told it wasn't important, a really important source of income for your zoo. So you're going to want to make sure all your exhibits have donation boxes, basically. There's Viraj. You can see Viraj is not the happiest tiger in the world, so we're going to try to cheer Viraj up a little bit. And if you want a video quicker, A, or B, where someone talks less, I'm sure loads of other YouTubers, I don't know who did behind closed door recording, but I think most of us who went to Gamescom did. So if you want to do that, I'm sure there's other people out there who do that. I'm just doing my thing. Gonna put down a water pipe thing. It's quite cool, all the items you put down, they kind of auto grapple onto the environment, if that makes sense. You saw then when I was putting the water pipe down, it kind of moved up the fence if you wanted to do that. We are gonna put a sign down later on, which you'll see does the same kind of thing and looks pretty great in the process. But Viraj is still not happy. The guests are happy, Viraj is not happy. There we go, this was the frozen blood pumpkin, my favourite item in the game. It is literally a giant pumpkin full of frozen blood, which apparently is a thing they do in zoos. I think that's a really cool enrichment item. And you see that Viraj's overall welfare is in the green, 78%. Maybe not the happiest tiger, look at it, it's beautiful. Maybe not the happiest tiger in the world, but definitely happy enough, you could keep him there. And this is despite not having quite a few things. We're gonna, you know, try to get it closer to 100% very soon, but the point is, you don't have to do everything. Bloody Nora. Give him a cardboard box. We're going to see him play with a cardboard box. Don't you worry, ladies and gentlemen. That is on the way. Enrichment is now 100% because the frozen blood pumpkin is the food enrichment and the cardboard box is the general entertainment. Again, unfortunately, you're going to have to see me mess around the terrain. I believe this one takes a little bit longer. So we need to decrease the long grass and increase the soil. So we've got the soil tool. And we're looking for the long grass, and we're just going to kind of try to knock it down like so. And I believe, if I recall correctly, it's kind of lurking underneath the structure, which is why it took me a while to get it. The soil's going up, though, which is the right move. And the grass long came down. Is it this one that takes... One of them takes me ages. I can't quite remember which one it is. It could be this one. Ah, it is this one. I do think the system could be improved. I'm just going to squeak this for a sec, sorry. Ugh, the agony. I do think the system could be improved a little bit. But like I said, it's beta, it's alpha even. And it may just be me who found it to be slightly inefficient as a system. I'm sure it's generally speaking pretty okay. But, at this point, I'm just hunting for the sand. I need to knock the sand down by about 3 or 4%. I don't know where it is. I'm just trying to find it. I'm just desperately trying to find the sand. There we go, we got down to 24. Now we need more grass as well. This was a common theme. And as far as I remember, it's hiding under something. But there we go. Got it a little bit there. I think it was under the rocks over there. Grass up a little bit. There we go. Look at that. It didn't take that long at all. Genius. Who knew? Who knew? Shocker. So Raj is adorable. Bad to play with the box, I believe. Looks great. The animals do look beautiful. They really do. The animations, the models, the sounds.
It's incredible. Slightly cartoonized, as you can probably tell by looking at him, but generally speaking, I mean, that's fine, right? Cartoony kind of suits him. Look at him. How's that not amazing? Done with that now. He's adorable, but terrifying at the same time. That's what you want in a tiger. And all big cats, I think. And there's Viraj, looking majestic as balls, ladies and gentlemen. Majestic as balls. Oh, excuse me. He's got nice privacy as well. So, next up, I believe, is the bears. Is it the bears? No, it's not. It's the tapirs, because of this little guy, Chantico. The bear's tapir had a baby, and I was a little obsessed with the baby, and decided to look at it for about 5 minutes. I imagine a lot of you won't care, because it is adorable. It is stupidly adorable. Those little lines, that little tail, look at him go. How is that not the cutest thing in the world? Exactly, it is. Yeah, I didn't really have the... You remember in the streaming demo, we had this issue wherein the breeding was insane, basically. Animals just bred all over the place, and we had like 10,000 babies. I really did not run into that. I played this for an hour, which is as long as I played most of my streams, and I really did not run into that as a problem. So I don't know if that was a problem with either the just settings in general, or maybe that was something to do with how that demo was set up, but I did not find it to be a problem at all during this playthrough. Now for our next new animal, ladies and gentlemen, this is why it's a bear, it's a new bear, but it is very similar to the grizzly. You know, I actually don't know. They had an obsession with this corner. They always went up and sat in that corner instead of the wall. It's because that's a shaded kind of area, and they want to get away from the heat, because these are not animals. They're Himalayan, right? These are not animals designed to be in the heat in the slightest. They're designed for the cold and the snow and everything like that. So you'll see them. Oh god, I'm a professional YouTuber. You'll see them go up and sit in the shade quite a lot to kind of stay out of the heat as much as possible. And to get the snow like this, as we saw in the streaming, you do have to put coolers down on the ground or the snow will simply melt away. You can apply contraceptives. Fun for the whole family. Still haven't given the sneaky information, just saying that's coming a little bit later on. There's our adorable Himalayan brown bears. We will be seeing the babies later on in the video as well, so keep an eye out for that on the way. But that is, you know, that's a building in and of itself. Oh, there are the babies, never mind. He didn't have to stay long. Look at him. They're adorable. They're inside each other, but that's fine. It's fun for the whole family as well. Everything's fun for the whole family. Amruta, a little Himalayan brown bear. Absolutely goddamn adorable. Again, I had a little obsession with the babies. I don't believe we see any more babies. I would have loved to see a baby gharial. If I thought about it, that's why I would have tried to die. I'm annoying myself. I should have tried to make for a baby gharial. We haven't seen a baby reptile at this point in time. I'm very curious. Actually, I don't think we've seen a baby. Oh, we saw baby ostriches. Baby ostriches are awesome. So we have seen babies of the non-mammalian variety, but not many. I want to see a baby Komodo dragon. Yeah, this corner. They love this corner. It's like being put on the naughty step by Super Nanny or something like that. But they love it. They can just chill in the shade. But the babies. Oh, there he goes. I mean, oh, just the best. I love this game. I know I've mentioned a few negatives throughout this video. I'm just trying to keep you guys informed of what my personal problems were, what was going on. You know, at the end of the day, this is a... Oh, you can reset, by the way. I'm going to click it eventually, yeah. So when they knock things into the water and can't get it back and stuff like that, you can just reset it and it'll go back to its original place. I know I've mentioned a few problems I've had here and there, but generally speaking, my experience with Planet Zoo really was immensely positive. I am hype for the game. I really, really enjoyed it. And it's worth remembering, I've played this game for 4 hours now on 2 different save files
on two different zoos with two different sets of animals, and it's really cool. How good the campaign is will be important, but still. This right here, by the way, is if you've got too many animals in your zoo, in your exhibit, basically the zookeeper is going to bring the right amount of food for your animals, right? If you've got too many animals and you don't have feeders, which is obviously the problem we've got here, then they'll just dump the food on the ground. They're still going to try to give the food to your animals because your animals need the food, but they're not going to put it in specific feeders. They're just going to leave it on the ground, which I believe is probably a little bit worse for their food scores or something like that. I didn't get confirmation on that, but it'll be something like that. About to see the roller in action. There he goes. Spins it. Some food topples out to the ground. Some sticks, some leaves, some meaty chunks. And our big old brown bear, big old Himalayan bear, I should say, is gonna chow down a little bit. Farhan. Big boy. Gives him a little booty boot. You can see that she walked around him. There is a collision system, I believe, in the game. It doesn't always work perfectly, especially in the alpha, but it is in the game. It's going to be a big improvement from evolution. We spend a lot of time in evolution looking at our animals. Yeah, sorry, I love the baby. Seeing our dinosaurs walk inside each other, it's a little bit awkward, especially since herding came into the game, but I don't think that's going to be a big problem on Planet Zoo. I believe it's not a big problem. I love the game. I'm so excited to play it. Ugh, I need the beta. 3 weeks to go till the beta. Basically 3 weeks from 2 days ago now. Less than 3 weeks till the beta. That's insane. Brown bear is... Ah, they're fine. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. It's fine. It's fine. I think there's... Yeah, they need more enrichment or something. I can't quite remember what the problem is here. Maybe there's too many animals. Yeah, I think there's... Yeah... Oh no, the problem here is actually their privacy. They've got this big open glass, and the Himalayan brown bear is an animal that quite likes its privacy. That makes sense. In nature, you would expect the bears tend to be fairly private. They don't really want to be watched and stuff like that. They'll try to scare people away. They want to protect their babies in particular. So what we're going to do is one-way glass once again, and that should hopefully fix those problems. You can see there it worked for those two, not for that one on the right-hand side, so we'll just select barrier again, hopefully. And swap that over to left to, yeah, like right to left. Oh, that's climb proof. Climb proofing, yes. Good time to mention this. Basically, because a lot of animals in this game can climb your walls and stuff like that, you're going to want to make some of them, or maybe, you know, there's a tree nearby which will let your lemurs climb up and get onto the walls. If you then want to stop them getting over the walls, you can make your walls climb proof, and it'll have this kind of metal system to the top of the walls which stops your animals getting out. Pretty cool. I think Kiara's about to go for a swim. I remember the water is filthy. I believe my filter went down. So I was trying to add a new one, and the QA person told me to... Were they QA? I'm really sorry if it wasn't QA. I have a terrible, terrible memory. I believe they were involved in quality assurance and testing and stuff like that. But I could be wrong. I believe this one should be hit by it, and it should. You can see that exhibit is close enough, but the problem is it died, basically. Now, we don't have all the specifics for it. Again, they're not there. You can see coming soon in the top right. But what we need here is an engineer to come and finish, or fix, I should say, our water treatment plant. And we're going to hire those right now. Mechanic. Staff do have to be put on paths, just as a general thing. And hopefully one of those mechanics is going to go and fix that nice and quick. There they go. The boys are back in town. Technically, the boys were never in town. The boy's in town for the first time. He's going to fix that up. And what you should imagine is these water treatments basically add a pipe system under the ground. They function, they service a pipe system under the ground, which then cleans out your water in that area. And we should see some lovely clear water here. There we go. Look at that. Beautiful. I love that little vent as well. The vent makes me happy. And that might be it for the brown bears. Aww. When I went to Frankfurt Zoo, Cologne Zoo, I should say, when we were in Gamescom for Cologne, we saw an animal. I can't remember what animal it was, but an animal just carrying around a big old cube that looked exactly like this. It's crazy just how on point a lot of the enrichment design and stuff like that is. Got a little indoors area there for sleeping and baby making and such. What else are we going to look at for the rest of this? I've seen only animals. We are going to take a little look at the terrariums very soon. There's a quick look at all the animals. I did ask what these leaf points were, basically. I believe these are for, especially for like rarer animals in particular. Yeah, some animals can't be released in the wild. I think they're ones that have been raised in captivity. Anyways, as you release animals into the wild and you earn ecological points, they wouldn't go into too much detail on this. I'm sure this is something that'll come up more down the line. But basically, you earn these other forms of resources, these ecological points, by releasing animals into the wild and doing generally good ecological things, I believe. And that will also let you purchase animals as well. It's a pretty cool system. The game really does want to reward you for being a good person, basically. This list does refresh. You can see every now and again, you can actually refresh it in the top left. All the animals have a little countdown timer of how long they're available for, so you should always see new animals coming in all the time. And maybe that means every now and again you won't see the animal specifically that you want, but generally speaking, it should be fine. You can't organise by species, sex, age, appeal, or price. As I was playing it, you saw me just there try to click on sex or age or something to try and organise it. Hopefully that gets changed. It'd be nice to have some sorting system for that. I don't know why that wasn't in the game. That seems like a shoo-in to me personally. We shall see. Quick little look at the blueprints. Nothing to there's a toilet. Is this where I add the sign? I believe I'm about to add a signpost. A very appropriate signpost, I'm sure they agree. Yes, Chief Beef, I believe, is about to be added to the game in the tiger exhibit. So you see it's on its back. So this is gonna show you a little bit of the construction. It's not in a great position. I want to put it on that wall in front of us. So we're going to rotate it around. And then you can see it's kind of, again, not at the right side. So we go into this. And we go into align to surface. And then we just need to rotate it again. If I stop being an idiot. There we go. Align to surface is great. So this, again, if you're going to just be decorating, this is the kind of thing you'll be doing. You'll be making Chief Beef. Look at that. It's beautiful. The dream. I can't actually remember what exhibit. Oh, it's a rhino exhibit, isn't it? Because rhino is Chief Beef. Everybody knows that. That's science. Look at him. The beefiest of chiefs right there. I want to see them use their skills as well. Can we get to the terrariums, please? I have info about terrariums. I want to give it. I'm excited to say words. I like words. Oh, yes, the tortoises. Because, again, I've never seen the tortoises. They've kind of been locked away a little bit. At this point, I love the little, like, how you fit the staff doors in and stuff like that is actually quite important. You really want your staff entrances to be out of the way, but also easily accessible all over the zoo. It's a really interesting balance. But there's the Aldebaran giant tortoise. You've already seen these on the stream, but I hadn't, so I was fascinated. At this point, I didn't know what animals I would be with on the stream, so I had to kind of check out basically everything. And you can see all these heat maps are really useful. We can zoom out really far and just see how happy all our individual animals are from a distance. And you can see the rhino is definitely not happy. It needs some food. The food bowl has not been filled at this point in time. Ryan is not a happy rhino at all. So we're going to get ourselves a keeper. That's me trying to put him in the exhibit. You have to put him on the path. You see a lot of keepers there. And you can see on the right hand side, they've got like work zones. So Mechanic South, Antelope and Tapir. So Emery Carlisle, the fifth one down, has two exhibits that they mainly look after. Megan Williams, the penultimate one, looks after the tortoise and the tiger. Roxana DeMarco looks after the exhibits in the north. You can set sort of areas where these zookeepers will specialize. And you can see there, you can pick the exhibit you want. Depending on what animals you have will depict how many zookeepers you might need. If you've got tons of elephants in a big exhibit, or like a big safari exhibit with elephants and rhinos and tons of other animals, you're going to want multiple zookeepers there looking after your animals, otherwise it's going to become filthy very quickly. Whereas, you know, one tortoise probably doesn't need round-the-clock supervision from a team of zookeepers, you know? So again, that's just... there's all these little systems in the game that kind of come together to be bigger than the whole. It makes it a very in-depth management sim, which is really nice. Even if you're not big into the management, I believe you could ignore it quite easily and get through the game. If you want to focus on creativity, if you want to just focus on the animals. But if you want to focus on that management aspect, you can see just by looking at the UI and the detail in the UI, that aspect is in the game if you want it. Now, I'd never seen the terrariums before, so I'm going to take a look at those. This is Jorge, or Jorge. I mean, it's your hey, the yellow anaconda. Gone, bro. He's in there somewhere. For some reason, I can't see him. Oh, we're just looking at the train. We can see him in the bottom left there. There's Yohei. He's a lovely lad. Chilling. Relaxing on school. Shooting some b-ball outside of school. When a couple of guys are not good. Sammy jumping and input. I'm not scared. Anyways, so. Cheeky little question. I'm hoping I can mention this. I asked whether we would be getting more styles of terrarium. I believe I specifically asked about a desert terrarium. Because at the moment, all the terrariums are the same. There's this jungle one. Now, you can mix up the items. There's three different tiers of item. And it adds like different logs and different trees and different branches and stuff like that. We might see it during this video. I love that little info panel as well at the bottom. Look at that. It's great. Anyways, I asked about that and she said she couldn't tell me. But, you know, I can't remember what she exactly said. But let's just say I got a big feeling, a big wink-wonk, that in the final game, or when Planet Zoo actually comes out, we will have multiple styles of terrarium. You won't just have jungle. You might have jungle. You might have a desert one. There might be one of it. I don't know a number. I don't know what they would be. But I definitely got the idea there's at least more styles of terrarium than this jungle one we've already seen. So, I just thought that was interesting. Because I actually like the terrariums. I do wish the animals moved around a lot. It does bother me less than I thought it would, I will say. I thought it was going to be a really big deal for me that the animals don't walk around in these terrariums. And it really didn't annoy me that much at all. I really got over it very quickly. And I will say, I was worried about that. The camera, I've mentioned this before, but the terrarium camera does not zoom in far enough. I want to be able to get right up close with the animals, and at the moment you just can't do that without using like NVIDIA Ansel, which I haven't actually tested out. Are we going to get ourselves a Titan Beetle? I believe so, at some point. And in here we have, Big Frog! Yes, Goliath Frog, the other new animal. It's a big boy. There he is. Again, this is like as close as the camera gets. I want to get right in front of his face. I really hope that gets changed in the final release as well. The camera just is not close enough for terrarium animals at all. But yeah, that's something that's pretty easy to fix, I think. Let's give him a little squeak. Oh, look at him! He's humongous! He's a unit! Big daddy. Nearly done, folks. We have talked for 52 minutes. Only 4.5 minutes left. Very exciting times. Abeke. I believe we finish off by getting ourselves a Titan Beetle. Remember, animal trading and exhibit trading, they're different. Giant Forest Scorpion, there's another animal. We don't get to see it, I'm afraid, in the video, but we didn't see it in the stream either. I don't believe it had been confirmed until now. To round up then, new animals. Goliath Frog, Giant Forest Scorpion, Mandrill Goriel, Himalayan Brown Bear, Baird's Tapir. Is that it? Have I missed one? Why do I feel like I've missed one? If we don't count the Indian rhinoceros, because IGN already kind of revealed that last week. I believe that's it, but that's 6 new animals right here, folks. 6 new animals! I'm going to call it an exclusive. It's technically not, because other people had the gameplay. No one has this gameplay. This is my gameplay. But other people do have gameplay of a similar situation. But you'll forgive me. I'm sure people will forgive me. Maybe. Elena. Elena has been discovered. Delivered. There she is. There's our lovely Titan Beetle Elena, chilling out, doing Titan Beetle things, which is assumedly not much, admittedly. Let me zoom in further. I want to zoom in on the beetles. And they've got terrain, they've got stud books, they've got welfare, they've got social groups, they've got loads of the stuff that the bigger animals have. They're not as detailed. I see the exhibit has no features, so we're going to see that in a second, hopefully. If I click the right thing. You see, the terrarium itself looks really cool. They kind of built this building around it to make it look interesting. But we go into layout and we can add, yeah, so we've got 3 enrichment levels. There's a log one, there's a leaf litter one, and there is a tropical plant one. And that just adds some stuff into the exhibit. It doesn't really matter, you just mix it up a little bit. It's more like a style thing than anything else, but you are going to want them in order to make your animals completely happy. Wait, isn't that one different already? Am I going crazy? It's got water in it. The other one didn't have that much water in. Have I gone mad? That's wetter, right? With the bamboo? Am I mad? I don't think I'm mad. I don't think I've gone crazy. I think that's a different jungle one than the one on the left. With the water. Right? Right? Yeah. I didn't think about that at the time. I don't know. I was very overwhelmed by the situation. I wasn't overwhelmed by the situation. That's silly. But, I kind of really just want to show as much as possible and get through it as well. I don't want to run out of time, and we kind of run out of time right about now. So, I was kind of just, you know, getting stuff done, to be honest. That makes sense. I don't think there's anything for this last 2 minutes. Let me have a little look. No, not really. I kind of just sat there and talked things out and stuff like that. So you can end on this beautiful little shot here. So, Planet Zoo. Coming out in 3 weeks on beta. 24th of September, I believe. 24th September to the 8th of October. Have I got those dates right? God, I hope I got those dates right. It's something like that anyway. It's definitely late September to early October. It's only a couple of weeks, but it should be a really cool beta. I don't know what it's going to include. I don't have any information on that right now. I imagine maybe an early level of the main game and then primarily a sandbox mode. I don't think there'll be a lot of campaign stuff in the tutorial. I'd be surprised if in the beta, I should say, I'd be surprised if it was. Hopefully it basically includes all the animals we've seen so far. I don't know if it would make sense to exclude them. Speaking of the animal count, I know some people have been worried lately as the world outside makes so much noise that terrarium animals are going to count towards the limit or something like that. I personally think we're going to end up with over 60 animals in the final game. That's my personal guess. I have a bet on about this, that the final count be over 60. So even if 20 of those are terrarium animals, which could be the case, we'd have 40 full-size animals. And people hear that number, and I've heard some negative reactions to me saying that, like, 20 terrarium animals, only 40 full-grown animals, and like, blah, blah, blah. That would be such a huge... I cannot get across to you how massive that roster would be. And that's me being not particularly optimistic in terms of size. That would be the biggest launch roster of any zoo game ever made, I think, by, like, a sizable distance. Zoo Tycoon 2 launched with, like, 28 animals or something like that. It's crazy. Times have changed, blah, 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 but... still, it's a big roster. You know, Jurassic World Evolution launched with 42, and that's only when you include the Fallen Kingdom pack, which released a month after release. So, in actual release, it was like 37. Or was it, like 47 after Fallen Kingdom? I can't remember. It might have been 47 after Fallen Kingdom. The point is, it wasn't that many. It wasn't over 50. We know there's over 50 animals in the game, but they have said many more than 50. I suspect over 60, but that's my personal guess. Because in Jurassic World Evolution, they said over 30, and we got just over 40. So I'm thinking, like, low 60s, personally, but we'll see. It's a really cool game. I'm really, really excited to play it personally. I know some people will be hesitant because maybe you didn't like past titles or whatever. We've not had a good zoo game in such a long time. I think it's natural to be a little bit hesitant, but I think it's great. I'm really excited to play it. And if you are still hesitant and you don't want to pre-order the deluxe edition, I will, of course, have tons of content on the beta when that comes out in a few weeks' time. And therefore, you can make like a more informed decision. If you're... you know, if money's tight, you know, you're trying to save up, or you're trying not to spend frivolously and you're not sure whether to commit to a game, just wait for more information. There's more information and there's more content on the way, so just wait and chill. At the end of the day, you're going to miss out on the beta. Probably not that big a deal if you're okay waiting. And the animals, the Komodo dragon, the pygmy hippo. I'm so excited about pygmy hippos and Komodo dragons. And then it's like a... is it Thompson's the third? I can't quite remember. I think it's a Thompson's gazelle. I believe you'll be able to buy those separately post-release. You could with Jurassic World Evolution with the Deluxe Edition dinosaurs, so I suspect that will be the case. They will be more expensive than usual if it's the same as Evolution, but the point is, you're not going to be locked out. So, you know. Anyways, I know I've complained a little bit now and again through this video, but I do want to say my experience with Planet Zoo overall was very, really, really positive. There's a few things I'd like to see changed, but it's an alpha that's perfectly natural. Of course, some animations need to be tightened up and stuff like that, but I had a really, really good time. Big thanks to Frontier for inviting me out and letting me play the game. I will, of course, have tons of content on the beta in a few weeks' time when that comes out, and... hopefully we keep getting new animals and reveals in the meantime, in the time leading up to that beta, and I will of course cover those right here on the channel as well. So, if you enjoyed this hour, God, I need to go sleep, please do hit the like button, I would really appreciate it. Saw tons of new animals today, so hopefully you guys have enjoyed that a lot. Sorry I couldn't show you the scorpion and a couple other things, but I think we hit most of the major topics. And across, I'm sure across the other videos that are all going online right now, you guys will get to experience absolutely everything. So... thank you for joining me. Remember to subscribe for more Planet Zoo. Cheers myself as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.